डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल टेक सेकंड स्टैंजा ऑफ एसएफ फेबल्स द एंट एंड द क्रिकेट। इन फर्स्ट स्टैंजा यू हैव नोटिस्ड दैट द क्रिकेट एंजॉयड होल ऑफ द ईयर, ही डिड नॉट डू एनी वर्क एंड ही डिड नॉट थिंक अबाउट द फ्यूचर, नाउ ही इज सफरिंग। सो नाउ लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट स्टैंजा। एट लास्ट बाई स्टार्वेशन एंड फेमिन मेड बोल्ड, एट लास्ट मीन्स फाइनली, By starvation he felt hunger, he was feeling appetite and famine, and there was lack of food made bold, he became bold because there was lack of food and he was feeling appetite, hunger, and that is why he became bold and finally decided. What did he decide? To meet to ant, all dripping wet and all trembling with cold. Now rainy season came, and in rainy season all dripping wet, his body was drenched, dripping, there was the droplets of the rain were coming out of his body, falling from his body, and all trembling with cold, all of the body was sensitizing because of cold, he was shivering with cold, trembling means shivering. So he was shivering because of cold in rainy season, as his body was drenched because he had no shelter. Away he set off to a miserly ant. Away means apart place. He set off. He started his journey. Set off means to start journey. So he started his journey. His journey was long, and he was to visit to long place. Away, that was apart, to a miserly ant, where miserly ant lived. So where did he start his journey? He started his journey to the long away where ant lived, to see if to keep him alive he would grant. To see, he is trying to find out to keep him alive, he wanted to live, he would grant if the ant gave food and shelter to him. He used for ant, to see if, to find out. See if means to find out, if to keep him alive, he wanted to live if the ant provided him food and shelter. Without food and shelter he could not live long, so he went to the ant to ask for food and shelter. So would grant him shelter from rain, so that he would not be drenched, he would be safe from rain, and a mouthful of grain. He wanted shelter to save himself from rain, and to remove his hunger he wanted food, grain. He wished only to borrow, he wanted only to take, he would repay it tomorrow, and the next day he wanted to return. I think the lines are clear. So now let us see the rhyming scheme of the poem. So the stanza, first line bold A, and cold is also rhyming in the same way, so it is also A. So A and A. Now ant is not rhyming with bold and cold, so it is B, and grant is rhyming with ant, so it is also B. Here rain and grain are rhyming in the same way, so these are C. And last words of these three lines, borrow, tomorrow and sorrow, rhyming in the same way, so these are D. So rhyming scheme of the poem is A A B B C C D D D. It is one of the nonet. Nonet is a poem, stanza of 9 lines. So it is a stanza of 9 lines. So it is one of the nonet. And the poet has used enjambment, as he has used run on lines. The sentence is not completing in the same line. Grant him shelter. So there is continuation of the sentence in the next line, so there is enjambment. Poet has used enjambment. Now note down some questions to attempt at your home. So why did cricket go to ant? Second question, what made him bolt? Third question, where did the cricket set off to? Next question, what did he call ant? And last question, what do you mean by the word famine? So ant and the cricket. The ant and cricket, ant and cricket are personified in this poem. Okay? So there is, it is fable because animal characters are there in this story. Thank you.